financial education.
1010 WOLB Baltimore and WERQ FM HD3 Baltimore.
The views and opinions of the guest and host you hear on 1010 WOLB
are not necessarily those of the staff and management of Radio 1, its sponsors, or advertisers.
Did something here on the computer. But anyway, we are back for the second hour of the Frankie M. Conaway at Al show with co-host attorney Tehma Smith Wilson.
Good morning once again, Baltimore. Thank you for joining us this second hour. Today we're having open conversation, so if you want to call in on the phone lines or text me on my text. I can be reached at 667-334-7242. I'm an attorney and business owner based out of Baltimore City. So if you need to update your will or your deed, purchase real estate property, or redeem your ground rent, please give me a call at 667-334-7242. If you missed the past broadcast or the first hour of this session, feel free to go online to YouTube, type in Frank Conaway Senior Show, and all of our information and past shows will come up where you can listen to it on your phone, computer, television, or share it with others. And once again, we're having estate planning workshop on June the 8th, Saturday, June the 8th from 10 to 12. If you would like to attend, please text me 667-334-7242 to confirm your reservations. Or you can send an email to ybrown@huber.org. We look forward to seeing you there. I received a couple of text messages of interest. Thank you very much. We look forward to seeing you all there.
And our other co-host, Robert Bob the Dean Dashiell.
Truth is a bucket that each of us is given to carry with us throughout our lives. Fill it with facts, not emotions.
All right. We're going to take a couple calls, and then I'm going to read to you about Project 2025. I tried to give y'all this as a homework thing last week to look it up and read about it, but I'm going to give it to you in case you didn't or didn't have access to doing it. We're coming to, in this order, Sherry, Dwight, Terrence, Roger, and Leo. Okay? And once the line is clear, you can call in and get it on yourself. 410-481-1010. Let's go with Sherry. Sherry, you're on air.
Yes, hello, everybody. Donald Trump had a rally in Bronx yesterday, and he really had a good turnout. And really, he is really bringing different groups of people together. And they are passionate about, I'm passionate about Donald Trump being reelected just the way people was out for Marilyn Mosby. And like I say, I respect Bill Gooden because when he believes in a person, that's a person that you want by your side. We don't, Mike don't agree on things, but I agree with Bill Gooden activists. Sometimes your emotions can get up. with you. But I got to ask Mr. Dashiell a question if I can. No, I'm going to wait to the end. Listen, Nathan Wade gave an interview on Joy Reid's show, MSNBC. Mm. And basically, he said that Scott McAfee basically was wrong in handling out the mendacity, and really that he had to go. Then I go to Fannie Willis. You know, she sent in a response yesterday with the appeals court because she's trying to get those six indictments that McAfee dropped. She's trying to reinstate them for those co-defendants. Now, Mr. Dashiell, Nathan Wade was at Fannie's re-election campaign thing afterwards, the party. Now, do you think he's still going for that apple pie? Mr. Only person that can answer this one is Mr. Dashiell, because I know you're not out there still searching for apple pie.
So what?
You think Mr.
I just took up my half gallon of apple pie last week.
Mr. Dashiell.
Yeah.
Because only a black man like you can answer this.
Okay. I don't know what that means, but okay.
Is he still searching for that American apple pie from Fannie Willis? You think?
Why wouldn't he be? That's my response.
I'll adopt that.
Why wouldn't he be? I mean, now he's currently out of a job. She's been reelected.
He's not currently out of a job. He don't have that job.
Right, he doesn't have that job, but that was like his, I guess, one of his biggest paydays, right? He has a law firm, but I would assume that $600,000 in 1 year from a law firm that wasn't doing anything remotely related to.
But we don't know what that law firm was doing.
Wait a minute. Is he going
doing a testimony? It came out.
Wait a minute. Is Nathan Wade and Fannie Willis still engaged and still involved in a romantic relationship?
No.
I have no idea, but nothing that has happened that I know of would necessarily change it.
Okay, they say they wasn't together. Well, I'd be glad.
You don't have to be together to do that.
But you had a question for Sharon.
You addressed Mr. Bill Gooden.
I'm just saying
because he posted something else on Facebook. I'm just saying there's a difference between having an opinion and telling a lie on someone.
And that's what
I'm
saying.
He just posted something.
Wait a minute, Sherry. Wait, Sherry. Hold on.
He just posted something on Facebook saying that the two co-hosts, who are both attorneys, voted to keep me from calling into the show. That is not true.
No.
We did not vote to keep him from calling into the show. And no one said that we voted to keep him from calling into the show. So you can have your opinion, but please do not lie on what people say.
And besides that, no vote is necessary. This is not a public forum. If I don't want you on the show, I pay for it and I just tell you, don't call.
That's right. We don't work for Radio 1 or Kathy Hughes.
You said you have Mr. Gooden has a view that we have a negative opinion on Marilyn Mosby. There's a difference between your view of having a negative opinion. No one said anything negative about her. We just stated a fact. She was found guilty.
Right.
That's not negative. Okay. It's a fact. So please separate feelings from facts.
Right.
You know, she was found guilty or she's been convicted of a federal crime, that doesn't mean that we don't like her. That's not negative.
I never met her.
You know what I'm saying? That's just a fact that was stated.
Now, Sherry, you and I we go back to Frank Conaway. That's how I met you. And we have not always agreed, but we have not always disagreed on things either.
Right.
But when you start lying on me, put my face without my authorization on Facebook.
Yes.
Instead of coming to me as a man, I come out the 1200 block of West Fair Street so I can handle myself. Okay? Bill Gooden from St. Louis just getting here, finding out what Baltimore is about. All right?
I've never had
a major difference with Bill Gooden. We've had Bill on this show for years talking about the water bills, talking about no one being able to see the guns and the dope getting burnt up and all that, never a problem.
Right.
But when you did, when he did what he did last Friday, I had a real problem with that.
Right, but Mr. Douglas, I get it. I understand. I'm just saying I still respect the man, but sometimes we can't.
I respect him too. I've never disrespected Bill Good.
And see, basically, I heard something today. Mr. Dashiell,
yes.
You keep saying MAGA.
MAGA, yeah, MAGA. MAGA, yeah.
What do you mean by that? Like, MAGA people?
What I mean is that I believe that those people that associate with and consider themselves part of the MAGA movement, Make America Great Again, what that really means is reestablish and reaffirm the notion that America is a country owned and controlled by white men. That's my opinion. That's right. That's my opinion.
Okay, because I don't consider that as fact. Just because
you're entitled to your opinion.
Right. And when you
pay as much as I do, you can express it on this show.
Well, I'm just saying, you shouldn't be giving out real facts. But I say, just because a black person vote for Trump, passionate about that, you just can't say.
Did I say that? I didn't say anything about how you voted. Okay. I said be a member of the organization, be associated with the organization. I don't care. I don't know
y'all
how you vote.
Have a nice Memorial Day weekend. Bye-bye.
You too, Sherry.
Bye-bye.
Before I go to the next caller, and by the way, Bill Gooden, if you want to call in, my co-host and I have agreed that we'll hear what you got to say. But in the meantime, I want to say this to my lovely wife. This is my anniversary weekend, and I want to wish my lovely and darling wife, I don't know whether she's listening or not because she's at work, happy anniversary, sweetheart, 28 years this Sunday. In fact, we got married on Pentecost Sunday 28 years ago. Of course, Pentecost Sunday came last Sunday, so it wasn't the same Sunday. But I just want to let you know that I love you and respect you, and I hope we have 28 more, although I'm going to be an old so-and-so by then.
You mean older.
Older. You're right.
Yeah.
Okay, we're coming back to Dwight, Terrence, Roger, Leo, and Jason. Okay? Let's go to Dwight. Dwight, you're on air.
Good morning, my brother Carlton. Happy anniversary to you and Darlene, and two of the finest people that I have met in this world.
Oh, thank you,
for a long time. I'm going to put everything I had decided to say. I'm going to say something nice, and I'm not even going to say what I had to say, because a lot of people, I sit here and analyze the show, right? A lot of people don't know the definition of dialogue and the other words that y'all be using, so they're confused, so they come out the wrong way. I'm a director, producer, trainer in the media. So I take your show in consideration and try to piece what's wrong with the conversation from the people, because the show is excellent. Okay, all right. And anybody don't like it, I ain't put my number out, but I'm on Facebook. You know what I mean? I ain't scared. Have a good weekend.
Thank you, Dwight.
Thanks for listening.
Memorial Day.
You too.
All right,
God
Dwight.
Bless all y'all.
Thank you, man.
All right.
Let's go to Terrence. Terrence, you're on air.
Hey, good morning, family. How's everybody?
All right.
Good morning, Daddy-O. How you doing, Robert Dashiell?
I'm fair to milling for a square.
All right, it's fair for a square.
I know that.
You done add something else to it. You know, awesome conversation that you guys had on the first part of the show, and a lot of people really hit the point right on the head.
Call back.
Good morning, it's Big Mike. How you doing?
Oh, hey, Mike. Terrence, call back. We had a little problem over here on the phone. Go ahead, Terrence. I mean, Mike.
Yeah, I was just calling in because Sherry, when I first used to hear Sherry, she hated Trump. I don't understand, man. You just switched all the way up. And then if you get into Project 2025, I mean, you'll see that she is voting for somebody that's calling for us to go back into chattel slavery, pretty much. They want to go back to the 1870s on our. I just don't understand.
I know what you mean.
You know, but anyway, I'm glad Marilyn Mosby got house arrest, man. You know, and I don't know whether this affects her law degree. Does she still get to practice law?
I don't think she's lost her license yet. Has she?
Her license will be suspended and probably taken. But the fact of the matter is that, you know, she's an educated woman, intelligent, and has skills that certainly, I would think, would have value outside of the practice of law. This would be a perfect example of the real commitment that we have in our community. And I always say, we don't have folks that are MIA. That's missing in action. We have folks that are left for dead. So if we really want to show those who exhibit and talk about their love for Maryland, let's see how many come up with some opportunities for her to get re-employment to support her family.
I appreciate that. That's a great point. And, you know, it's like when people are down, what are you going to do to help them when they get back up?
Right.
My brother, I appreciate that, man. God bless her and her children and her family, you know?
Okay, Mike. Have a good one. Tehma.
We have a texter. This is regarding the voting elections. We have a texter that said Armstead Williams at the Board of Elections.
Armstead Jones.
Jones?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, they're getting them confused.
At the Board of Elections said a flash drive of vote tallies was counted twice. When Sheila Dixon ran against Kathy Pugh, Dwight Pettit said Sheila won nearly every ward and precinct and still lost due to irregularities. But Sheila didn't want to employ lawyers and pay for a recount. All that being said, Armstead needs to go. Is it possible that they are changing votes, especially since it takes 10 days to come out with a certified election?
Well, I've been saying, I said it last week, or at least I know I said it the other day. I was shocked when I found out Armstead was still had the job. I thought they had got rid of it. Then you still had confusion down there. They just got through counting votes. And I remember Dwight was on this show when that situation happened, that he represented Sheila in that situation. And a lot of people, including myself, thought that Sheila was robbed of that election. So I'm seriously surprised that they got the same person in charge down there that's causing the problems. So, but I don't know who replaces the supervisor of election of Baltimore City. How are you appointed that? Is it the mayor do that or
no,
the governor?
No. I think it comes from the state. But let's put it down where the goats can get it, as your friend Joe Madison used to say, the Black Eagle.
Yeah.
Sheila lost. End of story. Yeah. Let's go on.
Yeah, she did. And she took it honorably.
Yeah.
Like some other people that were running for president didn't. Roger, you on air.
Good morning, Mr. Douglas.
Good morning.
Good morning, Tehma Smith-Wilson. Compliments to you, Tehma Smith-Wilson, because you will listen to reason. And, Bob, you got to stop straddling that fence. You're going to hurt yourself. So pick a side, Bob. Get on that side. Now, Mr. Douglas.
I do. It's side of truth.
You said that people are bringing up your name. I'm the one that brought up your name. You want me to tell you to your face what I said on the Senator show, or you're going to hang up on me? Because I will tell you what I said on the Senator show. First, I said that we were dancing on the coach's grave because we know the coach has been anti-Marilyn Mosby. And I mentioned the people who was in bed with him. Carlton C. Douglas in bed with the coach. Moon Man in
bed. Wait, hold.
Who's that talking? Who is this?
Roger or somebody. Let me tell you something, Roger. First of all, I was not in the bed with anybody. And secondly, we never was anti. And I don't know whether you consider Coach anti-Maryland or not, but we were never anti on this show. So if you're going to come on this show, come on with the right stuff, or you can get clicked off.
Well, you can weaponize your show because you pay for it, like Bob says. Your show,
What we're talking about, sir, is the truth and the fact that we never was negative against her, but we were not going to allow people to come on here and retry the case.
Well, we're not trying to retry the case, but what you say may not be what people are hearing.
I don't give a damn. Well, I don't give a damn what they're hearing. That is true.
That
could be true, but I don't give a damn.
That's right.
What we're hearing is you're trying to weaponize your show, trying to ban Bill. I listen to your show to hear Bill. I don't listen to the show to hear what you say because I know you're in bed with the coach. And if you're in bed.
Bye.
Yeah.
We ain't going
if
there.
If you really want to hear Bill Gooden's show, then give him some money. He can buy one.
He can buy one. And I know another radio station he can get on cheaper than here. Now, let's go to Jason David Williams.
What happened to Terrence? Did he call back?
What happened to who?
Terrence, did he call back?
Yeah, if you get a chance, call back, Terrence. That was an error done while you was cut off. Leo, you're on air.
Well, good morning, my friends.
Good morning.
And I love all y'all. I'm just telling you. I love you. No, thank you for your service to our community. Before making a brief comment about Sister Marilyn Mosby, I want to make a quick announcement. The Roots of Scouting organization, of which I'm president, is having its annual jazz concert the day before Father's Day. We call it our Father's Day Jazz Concert, Jazz in the Sanctuary at St. James Episcopal Church, Lafayette Avenue in Arlington at the Square. Jazz vocalist is Lady J. The Experience is a four-piece jazz band. And this fundraiser, it's a $50 fundraiser, including a hot lunch. So if you're interested in being supportive, it starts at 12 noon, from 12 noon to 3 on the 15th of June. Give me a call at 443-651-2578. We need all the help we can get to sustain our 501c3. 443-651-2578. Let me say, I was at the courthouse on yesterday.
Yeah, I saw you, Leo.
I thoroughly enjoyed the battle. You know who I am. It's been 65 years that I've been in the trenches, in the battlefield, serving as a civil rights leader and activist in the community. And I just love the fight, the good fight. And you don't always win, but that particular fight, we won. We won a battle. We haven't won the war. And the coalition that came together behind Marilyn Mosby, different ages and creeds, primarily black folks, is something else again. I note that you know many of the leaders who are there, many of those who are unsung, who were committed, and it's just interesting that Channel 45, for example, Fox 45, old nasty channel, they're still upset. I listened to the commentary last night. They wanted her to go to jail. She didn't go to jail. The prosecutor, by the way, Bob, was Sean Delaney. He's worked for Eric Barron, you know, and that company. And he said in the court conversation, he mentioned that Marilyn Mosby had gotten more than $40,000 on a GoFundMe page. So what? She lost everything in this battle in many respects, and she regained the trust and support of many of us who feel that she was targeted because of her race and political persuasion. We did not want Marilyn Mosby to become a political prisoner, and we feel that was where she was going, at the behest of Larry Hogan and the Fraternal Order of Police. And they transferred this conspiracy to the Democrats, and they got involved. So give yourselves a big hand if you were on the team or believers, the petition drive, the hundreds of thousands of dollars people spent of their own money to sustain this fight was a source of pride to me. I was so proud to see all these leaders standing up, men, black men and women, from this region and all around the country coming together. This can be replicated in the teaching of our children, our churches, fraternities, sororities, you name it, we can replicate this kind of pushback in terms
we've been doing it for 400 years. We've been taught how to be victims. That's our problem. We've been taught how to be victims. If you want to show your commitment to Marilyn, find her a job so she can support her family.
And not only also, Leo, they need to replicate it to get these fools out to vote.
Oh, yes. Well, I've said before, take your children, take your grandchildren, take your neighbor's children. That's a day off from school. Send a note, the email. They don't go to school that day. You take them and you show them by doing, no matter who they vote for, they've got to participate in the process.
Hello.
If we are to survive as a people.
Yep,
so
correct.
I thank you all for your courage.
Tell me you had to say something to Leo.
Stick to your guns and keep fighting.
Okay. All right, Leo. Go ahead, Tehma.
A texter on the text line states this, and this is something that we all should be aware of, but not enough emphasis is placed on this. Don't sleep on the story of Baltimore being the overdose capital of the United States. The New York Times and the Baltimore Banner did an investigative report, and it is very chilling. Not only is Baltimore leading the nation in fentanyl overdoses and deaths, but it is double the amount of the second jurisdiction.
Well, that's absolutely true. And it hasn't been talked about. I've talked about it several times from the funeral director's perspective. And it goes back to before the two of you were on here, when it goes back to Sister Nzinga and when Dwight was on here. And I told them that even those years we would have 300 and some homicides, it was four times that amount of overdoses because of fentanyl going on in this city. But nobody was really talking about it. That's absolutely correct.
And my question is why? Why do you think we don't talk about it?
You know what, Tim? That's a good question. I don't know why. I mean, everybody knows that Baltimore, historically, for years has had a heroin problem.
The heroin capital, right?
Yeah, for years.
Right.
Now you got a situation that you got a drug coming in here that's more dangerous than heroin. So dangerous, some of you may remember a couple years ago, there was a gentleman that had taken whatever he was taking and had fentanyl in it. When the two paramedics got there to treat him, they almost died treating him from the fentanyl. Because you got about like three types of fentanyl. You got fentanyl, some other kind of fentanyl, then you got another kind of fentanyl. Each one is more dangerous than the other.
Well, like alcohol and other drugs, I think fentanyl is a symptom and not the problem. The fentanyl use, drug use generally is a symptom and not the problem. I think the problem is that is not stated enough and not recognized. There's three things: anxiety, stress, and depression. Anxiety, stress, and depression. Those three things are the biggest killers in our community, and they affect us differently. Different people can handle different levels of stress, but the fact of the matter is that mental disorders are evidenced in many ways by different people. But generally, I believe that the economic pressure resulting from our lack of resources that produces anxiety, stress, and depression is the biggest overall killer in our community, which is manifested and shown in many different ways, including the abuse of all drugs, including fentanyl.
Okay. I think it's Terrence called. Is this Terrence calling back?
Hey, peace family. All right. I know y'all hung up on me.
No, we didn't hang up on you.
Not intentionally.
No, we did not.
I got to tie Carlton's fingers together. That's what we got to do.
I thought it was the pinky to probably jump out there.
No, it's all right. No, go ahead.
You got to watch that pinky sometimes.
Go ahead, Ty.
You know what? I tell you what. Great show, family. Great show. I do want to say, you know, thank God that Marilyn didn't have to do anything. Didn't go to jail. Didn't do anything. And the fight ain't over yet. But once again, is that we have to look at the positive of it. Because she decided to do something different for our community, she was attacked. And it doesn't just happen there. It happens across the board. But the most beautiful thing is that we all came together at one and stood behind that sister and her family. All right? One of the key things that we keep doing is we have to get to the part, it's us. okay, that we build these communities for ourselves. You had a gentleman on earlier, and every other word he said was white man, white man, white man, white man, white man. That ain't it. You got to look in the mirror, okay? All right? You have to keep that money in our community. We have to get to that part that, guess what? There's some people in our community that look like us that ain't us. You got people walking around here with that green, black, and red on their sleeve, but it ain't really in their heart, okay? We have to get to the part that we actually own a piece of this rock. You know, Robert Dashiell said it earlier, that guess what? When your feet hit the ground and you're born, all right, you're due a piece, okay? And it's a lot of people that don't feel as though that we are. And you can see that all the way back. And I'm not going to say, well, you already said it about the Obama for your mama. He didn't do nothing for us, okay? And we accepted and cheered him, and there's an accountability with that.
But Terrence, wait a minute, Terrence, hold it. Did we ask Obama to do anything for us?
You know what? We just like he asked us, all right, to support him, there was an accountability for him, it to be reciprocal, and for it to come back.
Okay, but you still have not answered my question.
No,
Listen.
We haven't gotten together on that yet.
Terrence,
yes,
listen.
Sir.
The Hispanics asked for what they wanted. The LGBTQ whatever asked for what they wanted. When he came in there, he was against LGBTQ whatever, BB whatever. Okay? He changed his mind on it. He did what he had to do for the Hispanics. But not at no time for the 8 years that he was in there did any major black group get together.
I was going to get to that. It's our leadership.
Okay.
It's our black leadership.
All right.
They're not
I'll go along with you on
accountability
that.
Of our community.
You're right.
Because when we elect them, all right, we elect them 9 times out of 10, black people are voting. They elect them because people look like them.
Yeah.
They're not taking the time to read the information of who they are and what they are and where they came from.
You're right. Okay. Thank you, Ty. Let's go. We're going to Jason, David, William, Bill, and we got a line open, 410-481-1010. Okay, let's go to Jason.
Good morning, family. I just want to say thank you to Mr. Douglas, who appeared on our program on Monday. It was a great conversation that we had on Monday.
My pleasure.
In reference to the election turnout and just your perspective and take on it. And just thank you so much. I'm about to lay something on the table here. I know that I'm going to get some backfire from the community. But I'm hoping that the folks in the community will go read Dan Roderick's article in reference to, you know, it's time for us to move on in reference to the whole Mosby saga. But I'm about to place something on the community that the community may have an issue with. And I suggest for your show, Mr. Douglas, if you have an opportunity, you should reach out to Isabella Cummings and invite her on our show.
We've had her on before, but we can try to get her back on. Sister Tehma's our booking agent.
I can make that possible for you. I just finished speaking to her. She's actually on vacation, a well-deserved vacation.
I'm not sure I share your impression of Ms. Cummings and her and how she's handled her duties of that office. But go ahead. I think I know some things that you probably don't know about it.
Yeah. I appreciate what she has done in her office. I know that many people don't when it comes down to, you know, certain individuals that may be put in the crosshairs or the radars in her office, like, for instance, the Mosbys. And she just wanted to just reiterate to the community, because she was hearing what was going on in reference to the conversation and realized that there's a lot of misinformation. She wants to explain to the community that she did not submit the investigation, which was initiated by Marilyn. Marilyn came to her office and asked her to investigate her business affairs in hopes of clearing her name and clarifying her business dealings, which unfortunately there were some findings that unfortunately didn't clear her. She didn't submit that report until February of 2021. That was under the Biden administration. So this was never a Trump agenda, although Trump did mention during the campaign trail that she should be charging herself for charging those officers. And although Trump did have a meeting with Mike Mancuso and the FOP, the nationwide, the national FOP organization, which I can guarantee you they weren't talking about qualified immunity or eliminating that. They weren't talking about constitutional policing. But I bet you that there were conversations in reference to a progressive movement and progressive prosecutors throughout the country that were charging officers. So I bet you there was a conversation there. But again, Isabella just wanted to just really state that.
Well, Jason, let me Jason, let me just say this, because I got to go. I got a full board here, and I know some other people want to call. We had Isabella Cummings on here when Dwight and Sister Nzinga were on. Now, what Bob is saying, I could kind of concur. We had her on before the whole incident with Marilyn happened. One of the questions I asked her specifically, I remember, was it seemed to have been the mayor, who Brandon Scott at the time, and some others on down at City Hall, were kind of against the power that she had. And I would question her about that, and she mentioned some very interesting things in that answer, of that question. Right. Since then,
that may be true, but she did say that Brandon's administration, and this is a quote that Brandon's administration has been allowing her to work, that out of all the administrations prior to, if you remember, Kathy Q.
Yeah, because she kind of backed him into
the corner. Eliminated.
Yeah.
Well, maybe that explains why she refused to investigate a situation where bid documents had been altered after the bids were submitted. Maybe that explains why she refused to have any opinion about Charm City.
And they are,
maybe that's why she
and that's
refused
the question,
to.
Bob, that we should face her with if she comes on this
show.
You know? We'll try to do what we can to like I say, she's been on here before, so if she wants to come back, fine. But when she come, just be ready to answer what we're gonna ask her. Let's go to David, William, Bill, and Lee. One line open, 410-481-1010. David, quickly, David.
Good morning, Carlton. This is Wiggins, and I just wanted to say I've been listening today, because I wanted to hear what you all were going to talk about. And, I advocated to bring the Justice Department to Baltimore with Frank Conaway, David Johnson, Darren Muhammad, and a few others. And I heard some comments today about activism. And I want to say this about activists, because I'm not an activist, I'm an advocate. I advocated for the people of Baltimore. And it's a thankless job to advocate for the people. But we did get that consent decree, and we asked Barack Obama's Justice Department to come in. You have to make them do their job. That's what Frank used to tell me all the time. And I love Mr. Frank. I loved him dearly. We were born on the same day, March 16th. We shared a birthday. But every activist in Baltimore gets a grant from the government. Damn near all of them. And I'm not going to call no names. But Jason, Leo, Bill, and all of them were in the room when Earl Saunders and Puneet Tehma of the DOJ told them that the Baltimore Black Think Tank has the answers for what you need lawfully. You are still crying about Armstead Jones. He was a Republican. We told you he was rigging votes. We told you that, but y'all laughed at him. You know, you have the grand jury. That they still have, Marilyn had to open the grand jury for Marcella Holloman. Now, the Earl Ivan Bates has allowed this woman, and she has a court order from the Court of Special Appeals on Brack v. Wells, where only in Baltimore City, black people are not allowed to take their complaints to the grand jury to have them investigated, like Kenneth LaVon Johnson did. And they said it was a runaway grand jury when he tied the drug trade in Baltimore to the businesses and the banks. And see, people don't want to talk about that. You have an article in the Maryland Constitution whereby 5% of the electorate can come together and petition and change the charter of Baltimore or dissolve the mayor and city council. And that's what? Article 11, E4, I think.
Okay, David.
You don't want no large
class. David!
Yes, sir.
We're dealing with time here. What is your answer to all those things you just said? What can be done? And do it briefly, because I got a full line here.
I can't do that. We have to have a community meeting and sit down, and the things that have been outlined for you to do are still there. Nobody's
Well, who's supposed to call the meeting? Right, right, who's going to call the meeting?
Don't. I hate it when people say nobody. We speak in such absolute terms as though we know, but yeah. We really don't. I mean, I understand that if you say, I haven't talked to anybody in recent times who seems to want to talk about that. But don't say nobody, because, there's a half a million people here. There's a half a million people here, and I have no idea what the other 499,999 people are talking about right now, and you don't either.
You know, when I used to say bring the grand jury to Baltimore, they used to laugh.
Well, we know all about that. Let's go on. You've been talking about that for years. But I still haven't seen. In fact, you moved out the state. I don't even know if you're back here, still out of state. And if that's the fact, then you need to come back here and get a movement going to get that done. William, you're on air.
What's going?
Hey, how you doing?
Fine.
How you doing, Carlton? How you doing, Bob? How you doing?
Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, good morning. Hey, I wanted to say to you all, Carlton, I've been listening to this show when you and Frank and the other guy started out in the show, okay? And nobody can take my black card. I do patronize black restaurants. It's a restaurant up on right up in the Hoover Memorial. I'm not going to say the name, but it's on Northern Parkway in Lockwood.
You talking about Collins?
Yeah, Collins. Great black restaurant. Wonderful food, man. And the same thing with the guy on 25th Street, right?
Taste this.
And
Terra Cafe.
Terra Cafe. Wonderful food. All I'm saying is that's what we need to do, patronize the black community, which I will. And I will, and I just don't agree on everything that we agree on. I think we just have two different opinions here, because as far as this voting goes, right, here I am, I'm blind, and I went out to vote, right? I went up in person to vote, okay? And I always go in person to vote. I think they need to eliminate those mail-in ballots unless you have a valid reason for not coming to the polls, because I think that, this is just my opinion. I'm not saying it for argument's sake. I think you have more of an opportunity to cheat on both sides, with those mail-in ballots. And one more thing, Carlton, which I know you ain't going to like, but you say that Trump was an election denied, but so is Hillary Clinton. She still denied the election, and that was before mail-in ballots. So all I'm saying is that I just think
but hey, William, she conceded. She might not like what happened to her, but she conceded.
Yeah.
That fool never conceded.
And still hasn't.
It still hasn't, All right, let's go to, in this order, Bill, Lee, Joe, and James will be the last caller for today. You're on air, Bill.
First and foremost, I'm going to say thank you for this opportunity. Thank you to all the people that came out to support Marilyn Mosby. First and foremost, Carlton, then, you don't go on my Facebook page. Butch went on my Facebook page, called you and said, oh, Carlton, Bill Gooden's over there.
No, that is not what. That is not what happened. Now, there you go with another falsehood. When I left this radio station last Friday, I had an appointment with a friend of mine. When I walked in her house, she said, who is this guy, Bill, that done put something out on Facebook on you? I said, who? I don't know what you're talking about because I don't have Facebook. She pulled it up. That's how I found out.
Okay, so say I lied about that. Okay, I accept that. But to say I lied in terms of giving my opinion was that I feel that all three of y'all had a negative view on Marilyn Mosby. Now, that's not opinion. That's not no lie. And I'm saying that based upon the conversations we had. Even today, Colton, I heard you say this. I heard you say they should use the same energy to get people out to vote. Did you not say that?
Yes, I did.
How is that negative towards Marilyn Mosby, though?
So the point is this. So if that's your view and if that's their opinion, then you should lead that charge, right? So the people that's leading the charge out there for Marilyn Mosby, then that's their view and that's their opinion that's the charge they want to take up. They don't make them wrong because that's the truth.
Nobody said they were wrong. What are you talking about?
Mr. Bill. Mr. Bill, you're proving our point. Like you just said, let me finish. You're proving our point. Like you said, if that's the charge that y'all want to take up, then let y'all take up that charge. And that's what we've been trying to tell you. If you want to take up that charge, feel free to go and take up that charge. If other people, but what I'm saying is,
I simply said that from my view that y'all had a negative opinion about
me. And I'm saying we never said.
Why was it important to state what you thought our view was?
Mr. Bill, we number one.
Hey, Bill. This is a dialogue, man.
Okay, go ahead.
Number one, we never said anything negative about Marilyn Mosby. Number two, you said if that's a charge that you want to take up, go. Y'all should be able to. And we encourage you to take up that charge. You're making us sound negative because we said no, we're not going to take up that charge. Just because we said no doesn't mean it's negative. Doesn't mean that we don't like her. It's just that's not something we want to do.
Yeah. Why was it important?
Why is that negative?
Why was it important in your support of Marilyn to state what you thought our views were? How did that? What's the connection between your support for Marilyn and yours and your assessment? Let me state it again because I want everybody to be clear. Why was it important to your support for Marilyn for you to characterize whether or not we supported her in your opinion? Why was that important?
I'm going to tell you why it was important.
Go ahead.
Because in my opinion, On Talk Black Radio, then I feel that the Talk Black host, if you don't support Marilyn, then you shouldn't be talking down against her.
Why is it that any opinion that's different from yours you regard as being against Marilyn?
Well, because we're only talking about opinions, and you said
why is your opinion on the matter even important? Okay.
My question is, what did we say that was negative?
Let me finish with this here.
Wait a minute. Hold it, Bill, because I ain't said what I had to say yet. First of all, your opinion is well respected. I have always respected your opinion, but when you go put my name and my face on Facebook, which you ain't never done, I got a problem with that. Now, that's got to do, as far as that, as I'm concerned, whatever your opinion was, you could have kept your opinion. Your opinion to be respect. Hold it, Bill. I'm talking. Hey, Bill, I'm talking now.
But then you,
Bill, you damn right I did, because I went on there. I wanted everybody to know that you told a lie, whether it was your opinion or not, on there and put me on there without my authorization or my picture.
My opinion is not no lie. How's my opinion a lie?
Because you told a lie that we were negative against Marilyn, and that was a lie.
That's my opinion.
No. You stated that as a fact. You stated it as a fact. You're characterizing it now in response to the opposition. But you stated as a fact that Carlton Jones. You stated as a fact that we were against Marilyn Mosby, and that was not true.
I am personally saying that Carlton Douglas, as well as his two co-hosts, which both are attorneys, have such a negative opinion.
And that's not true. And that is not true. You're stating that as a fact, but it's not true.
It's my opinion. It's not stated as no fact.
Well, I tell you what. As far as I'm concerned, Bill, whatever your opinion of me, and I can't speak for my co-host, but whatever your opinion of me, keep it off of Facebook. Now, let's go to Lee. Now, that's the end of that, because I ain't going to be on here all day, because Bob is absolutely correct. You put it on not as an opinion. You put it on to try to sway everybody that read that it was a fact. Now, let's go to Lee. You on air?
Happy Friday, family.
How do?
Hey, Bill, please don't put me on Facebook. I keep telling everybody this is a real show. This is a real deal. And I'm so glad that this show is still going on and Tehma put it on YouTube so I can catch it when I miss it. I got a couple questions, and I'm gonna go. I'm gonna just go ahead and everybody enjoy their Memorial Day weekend. Bob, you seem like a real smart guy. Let me ask you this, Bob, because I know the word around Baltimore was Marilyn Mosby was going to get 20 months. Is that true? Was that the word or not?
That's what the prosecutors asked for.
Right. Now, let me ask you this, Mr. Douglas or mm-hmm. Carlton. How in the world would she get 20 months for her case if a guy just killed six construction workers on a highway driving stupid and got 18 months? This is why I don't like the justice system. It is all screwed up. If you catch the judge on a good day, you might get off.
Well, see. Wait. Let me stop you because you're comparing apples to oranges.
Yeah, you're comparing
a sentence that was actually imposed with somebody's opinion of what sentence could have been imposed, and that's two different things. The opinion, the DOJ asked for 20 months. There were various opinions, including mine, that before. The movement occurred that she might get up to 18 months, but those opinions and those requests were against a maximum of 40 years, which nobody thought was going to be imposed. But nevertheless, the opinion of what the judge may have done can't be compared to what another judge actually did in another case.
And plus, there were two, you talk about a state charge and a federal charge.
I know, but even still, though, I just was confused that this man killed six people. Took
I agree with you. Off the earth. I was shocked,
she
too.
Was, yeah. She didn't kill nobody, and she was talking about 20 months. Man, we was going to have a sit down here in Baltimore if that was going to happen.
Yep.
You know that? Let me go real quick, Cox. Uh-huh. Any word on Elon Musk and his spaceship?
I hope he's on it.
Well, I don't even want to get into Elon Musk because it's so much.
Barack Obama is not black. Everybody keeps thinking he's black. Him or Kamala is not black.
Listen, Elon Musk, I got so many problems with Elon Musk that's got less to do with that going into space. First of all, there's a conflict going on with him even having that project. So I don't even want to go there. Okay.
And Barack Obama is not black, neither is Kamala Harris. People need to get that through their mind.
Well,
yeah, he's lying and she's an idiot.
Yeah,
we haven't had a black president yet. Please.
Wait a minute, his daddy was black. Now, his daddy was real black.
Yeah.
He was absolutely black.
Here again, we're talking about the color of his skin. We're not talking about the condition of his heart.
Well, I agree with you about the heart, but not to say that he ain't black. His daddy was blacker than me. Let's go to Joe, James, Dante will be the last call. You got to do it quick. Because we're getting ready to get out of here. Joe, quickly, Joe.
Hey, bro, it's still morning. Good morning to everyone.
Good morning.
Mr. Douglas.
Uh-huh.
I just have one thing. Remember what I said to you? This might have been maybe 4 or 5 months ago. But I said to you, all of them Supreme Court justices that they interviewed the Senate. Now they're coming back is exactly what I said.
And I agree. I agree with you then, and I agree now. I know exactly what you're saying. Because they lied. Yeah.
They lied.
They lied.
Okay. Now they talking about they trying to get them back because they ready to impeach them. Because they lied and it was clear and me and you saw it.
But here's the thing. They can't impeach it because they don't have enough senators to pass it. Now, what's going to happen, if Trump gets back in, Clarence and I think Alito is probably want to come off so that Trump can put two more people that will do the same thing they've been doing, but they're going to be younger with a lifetime appointment. And that's what's going to happen. Let's go to James. Quickly, James.
Yeah, they were interviewing Nick Mosby on Fox, and they asked him. He said he was glad that she was found, she had home monitored, home arrest. She could be home with her kids. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
So what's wrong with that?
He said her kids. Why didn't he say our kids?
Just a misspeak. I don't play too much into that.
You have to call Nick about that one. You have to call Nick about that. Last call for today is Dante. Quickly, Dante.
Hey, how y'all doing, man? It's Dante. You can check me out on Immaculate Deals on Instagram. I have a serious, very problem with us just being disconnected. But at some point, we got to leave the riffraff behind and enjoy life. Like, like the lawyer, Mr. Dashiell, goes on all them trips and stuff like that. We got to get to a different level of luxury living. You know what I mean? Like I said, like, I'm a broker. We can find you any type of luxury stuff. We need to start living different. We can't just keep on trying to figure out why everybody want to go to jail. That's not what life is about. If they can't see that, then they just can't see that. We have to move forward at some point. You get what I'm saying? So that's why I said we need to start figuring out what we're going to do now. What type of businesses can we open up so we don't have to deal with the 9-to-5 and so on and so forth.
I agree. We agree. Tehma, this note. Is this about my other show?
Yes.
On Wednesday.
People want to know about your other show on Wednesday, the time, and how they can listen.
Yeah. I'm on Wednesdays from 1 to 2 on a dial up from us. If y'all listen to Darren Muhammad on Saturday, I'm on that same station. Okay? From 1 to 2 every Wednesday. Close out. Tehma.
Thank you all for listening today. If you need to reach me offline, I could be reached at 667-334-7242. And don't forget to join us every Monday at 1 o'clock for Coach's Game Time Conversation. That's every Monday at 1 o'clock, Coach's Game Time Conversation with Coach Butch McAdams.
And your number, if they need you?
One more time, is 667-334-7242. Thank you to all the callers. Thank you to all the texters.
Bob.
410-547-8820 is my number. Enjoy your Memorial Day weekend. Read and understand.
And want to thank our engineer, Fats. Y'all be safe this weekend. This is Memorial Day weekend. If y'all going across that bridge, watch out. And be safe out in the streets. I'm going to try to get to this Project 2025 next week. I don't know if we have a guest or not, but I'm still going to get to it. I'm still going to try to get to it next week. Okay? We respect and value all opinions. So let that not stop you from calling. However, do not lie on us.
And remember, just because your opinion don't mean
it's
we got to air it.
That's right. Thank you. Every Friday from 10 to 12 here on 1010 WOLB is the Frank M. Conaway Senior AL Show with co-host Attorney Tehma Smith Wilson, Attorney Robert Bob Shields, and yours truly, Carlton Douglas. Goodbye. Don't want to be.
Talk in the day. Soul at night on the new 1010 WOLB.